The question is related to kind of Islamic history. So I want to know, I was reading a book called The History of the Khulafa Rashidun. So in that book, it says that when Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu became the Khalifa, and he went to Kufa, that Sayyidina Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu is the one who tricked him to remove him as the Khalifa and put Sayyidina Muawiyah as the Khalifa. So that was really bothering me. I don't know if you can put some light on that.
Jazakallahu khairan, brothers and sisters in Islam. Before I answer the question of brother Muhammad, we want to remind you of Minhaj Salaf al-Salih, the Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. Regarding the fitna which took place between the companions, namely Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu and Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan radiyallahu anhuma. First of all, we strive not to indulge into this fitna by talking about it. And the response of Imam Ahmad is an ideal response, I believe, when he was asked. He said, تِلْكَ فِتْنَةٌ عَصَمَ اللَّهُ مِنْهَا دِمَاءَنَا فَنَعْصِمُ مِنْهَا أَلْسِنَتَنَا. يعني بهذا المعنى يعني. This is a fitna that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has protected our blood, meaning our lives. We were not part of it. So we should abstain and protect our tongues from indulging into it. Also, I believe another predecessor was asked, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, radiallahu anhu, aw rahimahullah, someone who came the year 99 after Hijrah. And he said, تِلْكَ أُمَّةٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ وَلَا تُسْأَلُونَ عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. This is an ummah, a community that already existed and died, passed away. They will be recompensed or rewarded for what they did, and you will be also recompensed and or rewarded for what you do, and you're not responsible for what they did. So be busy with your earth. So that هذا هو المنهج. This is manhaj أهل السنة والجماعة regarding this fitna. So we don't indulge into it. We don't even explore anything about it unless you are trying to answer a question. Like the brother already brought the subject up in public, and refraining from answer it may invite people to assume that we don't have an answer for it. We do have an answer for every thing related to that fitna. So you have to answer, or you want to refute someone who uses that fitna to attack the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So those are the two occasions only were allowed, because we're supposed to defend the honor of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Regarding the actual conflict between Ali ibn Abi Talib and his party and Muawiyah and his party, brothers and sisters in Islam, as Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we believe that Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu was on the truth, and Muawiyah radiallahu anhu was well intended, because he was demanding the retribution for the assassination of the Khalifa, Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu an, since Muawiyah is the guardian, Waliyud Dam, is the one who is responsible for requesting the retribution and the qasas, the avenge for the blood of Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu. Although Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu did not mind that, but he believed, which we stand with him firmly, reading the events almost 1400 years later, Ali ibn Abi Talib was of the opinion to defer the execution of those who contributed or those who killed Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu until the situation is calmed down and situated. So it's both of them had the right approach, both of them are well intended, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who will hold them accountable for what they did. Although we believe that, subhanallah, that they done so much that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may forgive them. Now, when it comes to athar regarding this fitna, like the one our brother Muhammad from New York is asking, you need to understand that you will find a lot of fabricated, transmitted accounts regarding this fitna. And you will find it in reliable sources, reliable, like Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, for example, like al-Tariq, like, and so forth. But you need to understand that these scholars, when they narrated these athar, like the one that you're mentioning, that Amr ibn al-As, radiallahu anhu, somehow tricked, you know, Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhu, you have to verify the athar. The athar is not authentic. This athar is not authentic. It has someone who is known to be a liar. His name is Lut ibn Yahya. Lut ibn Yahya, in that athar, if you look at the chain of narrators, you will find him there. He fabricated so many ahadith regarding this particular fitna, again, because it was politically driven. And when you have a politically driven conflict, you have two campaigns. Both of them are entitled to write history, and both of them are entitled to narrate things. So that is the answer to your question, Brother Muhammad. I hope you got it, inshallah. Jazakallahu khairan. Barakallahu feek.